A master in silat cekak from Kedah uses only his limbs to defend himself.
So whilst I was growing up in and around London, the only self-defense that I learned was a quick headbutt and a sprint in the opposite direction. I mean, it's lasted me well this far, but I think it's about time that I learned some actual self-defense.
Jonathan! Come on!
Now my instructor for the evening is Kawim. Now what is the difference between silat and those other self-defense?
The most special thing about silat cekak Hanafi is that it practices 99% of defense and only 1% of attack mechanism. That's what special recommend. Everybody can learn. The young, the old, the fat, the thin, everybody.
Everybody.
The tall.
Even the tall.
If you have that commitment to understand the skirt, it's very simple, practical. It is according to human natural movement.
Ah, okay. And you're talking about steps. I mean, how many actual steps are there in silat?
Okay, in this silat, we have three basic steps.
Uh-huh.
The first step is peringkat asas. Second step is peringkat potong.
Peringkat potong is cut. Yeah.
And then the final is peringkat tamat. It doesn't occupy a lot of space for you to fight.
Ah, so it can be quite, it's mostly close combat sort of situations.
For example, if you are in a bus,
yeah.
You can see the passage in the bus very narrow.
Very narrow, yeah.
So you can fight even there.
Tonight has been more than just a lesson on martial arts. I know that once I walk out of this place, I'll leave with more confidence, discipline and the ability to stand my ground. Mr. Ustaz Hanafi, my hat's going to be tipped off to you for mastering this art after 40 years. You really have made me a better man, even in your absence. And to all the silat practitioners out there, I am most grateful to be accepted in your group, and I'll make sure that I'll only use my skills for the good of mankind.
We'll be right back. sepanjang kedewasaan ini. Ku ingin sampaikan pesanan, akulah penyambung warisan.